Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. In this video I would like to explain another example on method of variation of parameters, which is used to solve higher order linear differential equations with constant coefficients. See, this is the statement of the given problem. Apply method of variation of parameters to solve d square minus 2d plus 2 whole into y is equal to e power x tan x. Okay, see, given differential equation is d square minus 2d plus 2 of y is equal to e power x into tan x. Take it equation number 1. Here function of d is nothing but d square minus 2d plus 2, and here d is nothing but derivative with respect to x, and the right hand side function is represented by capital R, which is e power x into tan x. Okay, in the method of variation of parameters, in general right hand side function is denoted by capital R. Okay, first of all we have to find out the complementary function as usual. Okay, for getting the complementary function we should write the roots for auxiliary equation. So first of all, write auxiliary equation. The auxiliary equation of 1 is f of m is equal to 0. So some of the members can written as f of r is equal to 0, no problem. Okay, so in this function of d, whenever we have d, replace it by m and equate to 0, so you will get m square minus 2m plus 2 is equal to 0. Otherwise you can write as r square minus 2r plus 2 is equal to 0. So clearly here we are observing that this is a quadratic equation and which do not contain direct factors. So use the formula minus b plus r minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a. Okay, so what is a value here? A is 1, b is minus 2, so minus of minus plus 2 plus r minus root over b square 4 minus 4ac, so 4 into 1 into 2, 4 2s are 8 by 2. So m is equal to 2 plus r minus root over minus 4. It would be, what is root over minus 4? It would be 2i. Okay, because 4 is a perfect square and root over negative sign is nothing but I. So 2i by 2. So by separating the terms, 2 by 2, 1, 2i by 2 is nothing but I. So m is equal to 1 plus r minus I, which are known as complex conjugate roots. So in this case, how can we write the complementary function? Yc is equal to, it is in the form of a plus r minus ib. So e power ax, a is nothing but 1. E power x whole into c1 cos bx, b is also 1, so cos x plus c2 sin x. Okay, this is complementary function. It can be written as yc is equal to, take this e power x to inside, so you will get c1 into e power x cos x plus c2 into e power x sin x. Okay, so here what is u? I will take the coefficient of c1 as u, e power x into cos x, and coefficient of c2 as v, v is equal to e power x into sin x. Now we have to choose the pi, which is known as particular integral, which is represented by yp. Okay, by the method of variation of parameters we can take pi as yp is equal to, replace c1 by a, so a into e power x cos x, and replace c2 by b, remaining term is same. Don't forget one important thing, in the case of method of variation of parameters, always we can take the particular integral by using complementary function. Okay, replace the parameters c1 and c2 by a and b. Here a and b are not functions, they are also functions in x. So a is nothing but a function in x and b is also a function in x. Okay, we have a separate formula for getting the values of a and b. Okay, before finding the a and b values, we have to find out the Wronskian. Okay, what is the Wronskian of uv? Determinant of uv is the first row and the second row is u dash v dash. This is nothing but uv dash minus u dash v. So u dash v dash are nothing but derivatives of u and v. Okay, u is the similar term, e power x into cos x, bracket open, and what is derivative of v? V is nothing but e power x into sin x. So two functions in product, that's why I will use the differentiation in the product. Okay, derivative for f is e power x, derivative for e power x is itself, and sin x is similar term plus, now f is similar term, derivative for sin x is cos x by applying product rule in the differentiation. Minus is there, so minus u dash, take a bracket, here also two terms are in the product, so I will use the multiplication rule in the differentiation. Already you are all know very well about the derivatives of derivative of uv. Okay, e power x is derivative of e power x is e power x, and cos x is similar term, plus e power x is similar term, derivative for cos x is minus sin x, but already here we have positive sign, so positive into negative is negative, that's why I am writing here negative sign directly. Now separate the terms, e power x into e power x, bases are equal, so you can add the powers, e power x into e power x is e power 2x, cos x into sin x. Okay, now next term, e power x into e power x, e power 2x into cos x, cos square x. Here this is the derivative for u dash, and v is there. What is v? E power x into sin x, don't forget it, e power x into sin x. Okay, so now e power x into cos x, e power x into sin x, minus e power x cos x sin x, minus into minus, plus e power 2x into sin square x. We are observing that first term and last but one term are getting cancelled because they were same but are of opposite signs. In the remaining two terms, e power 2x is the common term, so e power 2x into cos square x plus sin square x. Okay, here you have e power 2x, here also you have e power 2x. So what is cos square plus sin square x? It is the standard identity in the trigonometry, which is 1, e power 2x. So however, I got Wronskian of uv is e power 2x. Before getting the values of a and b, you should find out the Wronskian of the uv. Okay, now it is enough to find out the a and b values. After getting a and b, replace that values in yp. Okay, you can give the equation number 2 for yp. Okay, see, now the formula for a is equal to, already you know it, minus of integral vr whole by uv dash minus u dash v dx. Okay, this is nothing but Wronskian. You can also written as denominator as w of uv. Okay, as you wish. So minus integral, what is v value? V is nothing but e power x into sin x, e power x into sin x, into what is capital R? Capital R is nothing but right hand side function in the given problem, which is e power x tan x whole by, this denominator is nothing but e power 2x into dx. Clearly we are observing that e power x into e power x is e power 2x, because bases are equal, you can add the powers, x plus x is 2x, that's why e power 2x getting answer. So minus of, what is sin x into tan x? Tan can be written as sin by cos, already sin is there, so sin into sin, sin square x whole by cos x into dx. So here I will write sin square x as negative sign is there, don't forget this negative sign, sin square x is nothing but 1 minus cos square x whole by cos x into dx. Okay, so that is equal to, separate the terms, minus into integral 1 by cos x, it would be secant x into dx, minus into minus plus cos square by cos, one cos getting cancelled, another cos is there in the numerator. So cos x into dx. So what is the integral secant x? Already we know that minus, already minus is there, log mod secant x plus tan x plus integration of cos x is sin x. This is the value of a. Some of the members can also written as a of x. Okay, now what is the value for b? The formula for b is integration of u r by Wronskian of u comma v. This is nothing but uv dash minus u dash v dx. Replace the values. So what is u? E power x into cos x. E power x into cos x into what is r? Right hand side function. E power x into tan x by e power 2x. Okay, so here also e power x, e power x, e power 2x getting cancelled. So what is integral cos x into tan x? Already you know that tan x can be written as sine by cos, but in the numerator we have cos. So cos cos getting cancelled, directly we will get sin x into dx. So what is integration of sin x? Minus cos x. This is the value of capital B. Okay, now replace the values of a and b in equation number 2 so that you will get yp value first. Okay, see. So equation 2 implies yp is equal to, first write capital A value, which is minus log mod of secant x plus tan x plus sin x. Once look at the equation number 2. So a into e power x into cos x. Don't forget to multiply a value with e power x into cos x plus b value, which is minus cos x, into e power x into sin x. Okay, if once you see the equation number 2, you can understand this term. Now separate the terms. So minus, first I will write this term, e power x into cos x into log mod secant x plus tan x. Okay, plus e power x into cos x into sin x. Just I am multiplying every term with e power x into cos x. Okay, every term of this term with e power x into cos x. Now plus into minus, minus e power x into cos x into sin x, they are all in product. So clearly these both are same but are of opposite sides, that's why they will get in cancelled. Finally we conclude that yp is equal to minus e power x into cos x into log mod secant x plus tan x. Okay, this is yp. Finally we should write the general solution. Don't forget to write the general solution in the climax. Okay, general solution of 1 is y is equal to yc plus yp. So what is yc? E power x whole into c1 cos x plus c2 sin x plus yp is nothing but negative, that's why you will get negative of e power x into cos x into log mod secant x plus tan x. Okay, don't forget it. In the next video I will give some more problems on method of variation of parameters, which is very important method to solve the second order linear differential equation with constant coefficients. Thank you very much.